This is a KTEXAS News update.
Good Wednesday morning. Leading our news today, a Coleman man is badly injured after a homemade bomb exploded near his Humvee in Iraq. 32-year-old Army Sergeant Shiloh Harris is the only survivor from Monday's explosion. Family members got word of the accident Tuesday, and Army officials warned them they may not recognize him through the severe burns he suffered. A Breckenridge boy continues the battle for his life this morning. Burns cover 30% of Ethan Collins' 5-year-old body. He is listed in critical but stable condition at the burn unit at Parkland Hospital in Dallas. Two other people died in that Monday morning fire in Breckenridge. 15-year-old Jody Hash died at the scene, and 55-year-old Russell Max Collins died at the hospital. Voters will decide on a $7.9 million Hawley school bond issue on the May ballot to build a new elementary school. Current problems force the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality to cite the district. Now let's get a check of this morning's weather with Storm Team meteorologist Chad Garneau. Good morning, Chad.
Good morning, Lauren. Good morning, everybody. It's going to be hard for everybody to be frowning about today's weather because we're going to see highs into the 70s and a lot of sunshine out there. As you see, the low pressure system is moving well off to the south. And with this, the wind speeds are going to calm down, it looks like. High pressure is going to be also building into the area. It's going to leave for a very nice, bright, sunny day. 74 degrees and winds calming down to the southwest at 5 to 15 miles per hour. For this evening, if you switch the numbers around, you're going to get tonight's low at 47 degrees. Mostly clear out there, so you are going to be able to see the stars, and winds really calm to the southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. And the 7-day forecast showing us that we'll keep the 70s until Friday, where we could get a chance of some severe thunderstorms. So keep it tuned in here to KTEXAS for the latest updates on that system. And then Saturday, maybe leftover showers with the system. And then temperatures falling off into the 60s and upper 50s for the start of next week. That is a look at your weather for today. Have a wonderful Wednesday.